State the domain and range of the function y is equal to the square root of 4 minus x. Well, first of all, let's recall the meaning of domain and range. The domain is the set of valid inputs, and the range is the set of corresponding outputs. To get a better feeling for what that means, let's make a small table of values. Let's check and see whether negative 5, 0, and 5 are valid inputs. We'll start with negative 5. Substitute negative 5 for x, and we get 4 minus negative 5 is 9. The square root of 9 is 3. Negative 5 is a valid input because it produces an output of 3. Negative 5 is in the domain, 3 is in the range. Let's check 0. When we substitute 0 for x, we get 4 minus 0 is 4. The square root of 4 is 2. So 0 is a valid input. It's in the domain, and the corresponding value of 2 is in the range. Now let's check 5. When we substitute 5 for x, we get 4 minus 5 is negative 1. But the square root of negative 1 is not a real number. It's imaginary. Therefore, 5 is not in the domain of the function. The value of 5 is not in the domain of the function because it causes the radicand to be negative. That suggests a way for finding the domain of our function. Determine all the values of x such that the radicand is not negative. In other words, the radicand is greater than or equal to 0. Our radicand is 4 minus x, so we substitute 4 minus x for the radicand. That gives us 4 minus x is greater than or equal to 0. To solve this inequality, we can add x to both sides. We get 4 is greater than or equal to x, or equivalently, x is less than or equal to 4. To reinforce this numerically and graphically, we can use our graphing calculator. Go to y equals and enter the square root of 4 minus x. To create a table of values, go to Table Set, which is second window. Let's start at negative 5. And instead of incrementing by 5 like we did earlier, let's increment by 1. To view the table, press second and then graph. Notice that negative 5, negative 4, negative 3, and so on are all in the domain of the function, because they produce corresponding y values. But if we scroll down through the table, we see that after 4, the calculator produces error messages. So this is consistent with what we've found. When x is less than or equal to 4, y values are produced, and therefore the domain is the set of x such that x is less than or equal to 4. To reinforce the domain visually, we can create a graph. Let's go to Zoom and select Zoom Standard, which is number 6. Visualizing the graph from left to right, we see that the graph continues indefinitely to the left, but as we go to the right, the graph stops once we get to x is equal to 4. So in interval notation, the domain of our function is the interval from negative infinity to positive 4. And we use a bracket at x is equal to 4 to indicate that 4 is included. When x is equal to 4, the corresponding y value is 0. So the correct answer for the domain is B, the interval from minus infinity to 4. Well, what about the range? Well, the range is the set of corresponding outputs. In our table, we see that the smallest corresponding output is 0, and the remaining outputs are non-negative. Visualizing our graph from bottom to top, we see that the starting point is at y is equal to 0, And then the y values continue to increase, and they're going to continue to increase without boundary. And so our range starts at 0 and then goes to infinity. We write that in interval notation as the interval from 0 to infinity. The range is the set of all non-negative numbers, which corresponds with E.